every so often, something happens that shakes you to your core, forcing you to take a deeper look at the world around you. Lately, it feels like I've been shaken more frequently than I care to admit, primarily due to the rising fentanyl epidemic. And if you're not alarmed, perhaps it's time to sit up and take notice. Last night, I was reminded of the heartbreaking reality many face as I spoke to a distressed individual. Her niece is trapped in the vicious cycle of fentanyl addiction. The advice I found myself giving was that she should assure her niece of her unwavering love and support, but inside, a part of me screamed to take drastic measures to ensure that she was safe at all costs. But that isn't the solution. In the very next conversation, news reached me of another life lost to an overdose. Heartbreakingly, this has become a familiar narrative for me and countless others. Messages of such tragic incidents arrive with a frequency that is both staggering and deeply distressing. While a part of me wishes for a sense of numbness and ability to cope better, another part resents even the thought of becoming desensitized to such a massive societal issue. Daily, families are being shattered as they lose sons, daughters, siblings, parents, and other dear ones to the silent killer. It's unfolding before our eyes in real time, and yet as a society, we appear paralyzingly stagnant. Yes, there are individuals and organizations passionately advocating for change, but collectively, our response is lacking. Through my role as the host of the Ashton's Dawson podcast, I've had the somber task of documenting many, many stories of those affected. The sheer volume of names has become overwhelming to the point where I fear unintentionally leaving someone out and causing further hurt. I repeat, so many people that are attached to even my life in a primary or secondary way have died that I have literally lost count. There are voices out there with extreme views. Some propagate a strict abstinence approach, suggesting that one should let addicts reach their absolute lowest. On the other hand, harm reduction advocates urge understanding and respect for individual rights, contending that forced treatment is not the answer. The common thread binding us all? The hope that in the next message or phone call, we won't hear of another overdose. Another life cut tragically short. The hope that we'll be strong enough to offer a listening ear and a comforting word or helping hands to someone in need. But above all, the fervent wish that we didn't have to navigate such a heartbreaking reality. In truth, I don't have all the answers. Hell, I don't have any of them. But what I do know is that we need to find them, and soon, because the cost of inaction is too high and the stakes are just too great.